seconds have begun. On this side, we have the blue team with Sid,
Tom,
Molly,
George.
And over on this side, the challenger, the evil faced competitor, the red team with Shane,
Seth,
Lloyd.
That's Clara.
And these two teams will be competing for your laughs by playing some games, some improv games. But we have to establish a few ground rules here first. Here at OKC Improv, for the improv games, we like to exercise a little rules on them. So we're going to have some fouls.
Fouls.
I love that word, foul. Here's the fouls. So first, political foul. We get it. You came to a comedy show to escape. We don't want to talk about politics like they do on Facebook and Twitter, right? You know, let's go away from that, right? So if someone says something political at all in the show, they have done the political foul, and they must come right here, center stage, and sing a patriotic song to you as an apology. Second of all, the dirty dog foul. If one of the players says a word that would make your grandmother potentially blush, they must come up here and apologize to you, the audience, in the form of a poem. It'll be very sweet. It'll be very sweet. And finally, y'all get to make up a foul. So, for instance, like if someone does this, they must do this as a punishment. So, what's something if they do?
Mention an animal.
This will be challenging for some more than others. If they mention an animal, what must they do as an apology to you?
Tap dance.
They mention an animal, they must come up center stage and apologize to you in the form of a tap dance. Perfect. All right, so those are our fouls. Now, are you guys ready to get the improv game started? Our first game is called I'll Ask the Questions, and it's for everybody. So we're going to have two people from each team come on up first. What they will be doing, one person, yes, and they will be, they can only speak in questions. If they speak in a statement, if they use a Canadian question, I got you something at the supermarket, right? Then that is a Canadian question, and they're out. Also, if there's a lot of repetition, what do you think? Well, what do you think? Blah, 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 blah. They're out, right? So they must speak in questions, and I have the final say because I'm the referee and I can do what I want. Okay! For every person lapped, they will get a point, and we'll keep going until I'm satisfied. that's how this works. To get this scene started, this first question scene started, where's a place you might find a lot of people, like the zoo or the park or
the zoo?
I like the way you think. Here we go. Might see some tap dancing tonight. All right. Y'all, this game is called, this is questions. We're going to be at the zoo. We'll see how this goes. We're going to start all our games out by saying 3, 2, 1, action. Can you do that with me? And
3, 2, 1, action!
Have you seen where the French fries are?
No.
Are you going to the Aquatica show?
Well, what do you think I should do?
Well, are you?
How could you ask me such a thing?
Did you bring enough money?
What is money?
Who knows?
How did I get in here?
You're gonna get me something at the gift shop?
What do you want at the gift shop?
Do they have stuffed penguins?
Do they have stuffed cheetahs?
Can I get my mommy a necklace?
Sure.
Jerry, have you seen any four-legged furry things around here?
Nope.
Oh!
No, have you seen my dad?
Look, I'm looking for those big things with the wrinkles. They remind me of, you know, old mammoths, but they're elephants or something.
Out of there! Where can we get Dippin' Dots around here?
Have you seen anybody besides us around here?
Have you seen anybody besides you around here?
Am I an animal?
Yeah.
Where's your mother, little one?
But is she by the tigers?
Did you see the results of this paternity test?
Don't you like throwing popcorn into the pit?
Who do you think I got this popcorn for? Them and me!
Aren't you one of the zookeepers?
You want to put me in a little box, don't you?
Would you move out of the way? I'm trying to sweep this place.
Can I have that? Thanks.
The blue cheese twice. Y'all, this is an exciting improv game for sure, and I'm sure we haven't seen the last of tap dancing.
This next game is going to be called Columns, and because Team Red is in the lead, Team Blue is going to go first. So what I need is, two audience volunteers who don't mind coming up and saying some words to help our improvisers out. Any volunteers?
We've
got one in the back. Right here?
Yes.
Okay. Being voluntold, I see. Just come right on up and take a seat. Take a seat. What's your name?
Autumn.
Autumn and? Peter?
Yes.
Autumn and Peter, everybody. The blue team come out. So these two folks are going to play a game called Columns, and what's going to happen is they're going to tap you on the shoulder every time they need inspiration, so you'll just fill in the blank. So if I said, like, I really want to go to the zoo and I really want to see a
large giraffe.
Large giraffe. Okay. Et cetera, right?
So y'all can really screw them in this game, by the way. Just heads up.
So they'll fill in the blank, and y'all can say anything. It can make sense or doesn't have to make sense. It's up to y'all. So, to get this scene started, for the blue team, can we please get a relationship like brother, sister, cousins, or coworkers, or
ex-spouses?
I'll take ex-spouses.
Ellis.
Come on.
Sorry, y'all. Ex-spouses, and we're going to get this column scene started in
3, 2, 1, action!
Jerry, my gosh, what are you doing here?
Well, I'm looking for the...
alien exhibit.
I'm looking for the alien exhibit. It's so cool!
Jerry, I didn't know you liked aliens. I thought you liked...
pink elephants.
I do. I really like those things, those pink big things, but I like them best. I like them best when they're being sucked up through a tractor beam in and out on a large spaceship.
Jerry, everybody knows that aliens don't exist. It's just a government propaganda. What's really happening is, it's not a spaceship, it's a...
Russian.
It's a Russian. The Russians are doing it. They do everything these days.
Adam, that's why I left you. It's always the Russians with you. Always the Russians. I opened up the cabinets and, oh no, don't open up the cabinets. The Russians are there. Don't get the mail. The Russians are there. Brings in the black helicopters. Whew, I had to go. You know where I went? I went...
To Mars.
I went to Mars.
Jerry, you're always making up these stories. First, you're going to Mars, and last year, right before we broke up, you said you went to...
Phoenix.
Phoenix! That doesn't exist!
Don't you remind me of Phoenix, and don't you remind me of the breakup. That was hard on me!
It was hard on you?
Yes!
It was hard on me!
It was hard.
I cried for weeks!
You cried for weeks?
I almost moved to...
Arizona? No, let's go with New Zealand.
Arizona? Yeah. That doesn't exist. New Zealand!
My God! You almost moved to New Zealand!
New Zealand!
I can't believe that, because right after you decided to move to New Zealand, but you didn't, I went to...
Inhabited Kiwi.
I went to an uninhabited Kiwi, and I had lots of Kiwi.
Kiwi is a type of bird.
Oh, it's a kiwi is a type of bird, but it's also a people in New Zealand. Also people in New Zealand, and that's what I was talking about. But I'll tap dance.
Jerry, you're rambling. You're talking to people that don't exist. Pulling these words out of the air.
You gotta believe me. They sucked me up into their ship, and you know I don't want to talk about the rest. It was horrifying. Have you ever had a colonoscopy? It's sort of like that, only with bigger tools.
I've never had a colonoscopy, but I have had a...
Man of my dreams.
I have had the man of my dreams. It was you, Jerry, before you broke my heart from the Russian. It's me.
All right. Come back to me, but never mention the Russians again. Never! And we can be together forever.
Jerry.
And not the Swiss either.
Fine, I won't mention the Russians.
No Swiss, no Russian.
I won't mention those, but I will mention...
China!
let me keep China.
All right. You can have China, and I'll have Australia. I'll build up my armies there. And I'll go up through Siam. And we can play all night.
You're playing too many games.
Look.
This is all a game to you, isn't it? Life is a game to you, isn't it?
Look, I'm going to give you one thing. I'm going to give you a...
A porcelain china dinnerware set.
I happen to have a porcelain china... I've been saving it for you. I knew I'd run into you. The aliens told me. They sucked me up. They used the big probes and told me, hey, you're going to run into him. The person that you need to be with for the rest of your life.
This is fate, Jerry. I believe in you.
Yes.
I love you.
Oh. I love you too.
Oh.
I love you too.
Oh, that's my game! Awesome. Thank you, guys. Thanks, our volunteers. We're going to give the red team a chance to play this game, and then you're going to vote for which scene you like the best. So remember that scene in your brain. Can I get two more volunteers who don't mind coming up and helping us out? One right here.
Oh, it's you.
Any one more, please? One more? All right, right here. Awesome. Tap you on the shoulder, fill in the blank. So to get them started, can we get another relationship for them, please? A different one.
Brother and sister, please.
Sister. We're going to see this brother-sister scene. Count it down with me in 3, 2, 1, action!
Bernice!
Jeremy!
Have you seen my jock strap, Bernice? I can't find it. I think I left it in the...
Bathroom!
I don't know. Maybe you should put things away sometimes on your own instead of putting them on the bathroom floor like some other... Janitor set.
All I wanted to be when I grew up was a janitor. You think I can do that someday?
I believe that you can put your mind to whatever it can be. Whatever you can do. Like your mind can be a janitor.
Like if my mind went over here,
And then I took it, and I found a nice little spot that was right over...
Nowhere.
Nowhere! That kind of I think it makes sense.
What have they taught you in detention, Jeremy? Have they taught you how to think things? Did they teach you things like...
Nothing.
Like nothing? They taught you nothing? What do I do, pay for detention? This is what I get?
God, you're right. In detention, we just sat around and played...
Parcheesi.
I've spent the last 3 years playing Parcheesi.
Oh my God, I could have been backgammon.
No one plays Parcheesi.
No one plays Parcheesi. They should be playing...
Tag.
They should be playing tag. Like, you know, tag, you're it.
How familiar.
I had to remind myself, Jeremy. It's been a while since I was in detention.
You remember when we were kids and Mama used to whip us up a big bowl of...
Milk.
Milk? That was some good milk right there. Oh, man, I get a hold of my face and you wipe me one of those.
Yeah, I was embarrassing like that. Well, you know, I just remember she would go over with that pail over to get the milk from the...
Freezer.
From the freezer?
Freezer milk, man.
It's like it could have been a popsicle, but it wasn't. It was in the freezer, but there was no stick in it. It was just in a bucket.
You know, I stuck my stick in a lot of things growing up.
That's why you're in detention, Jeremy.
That's what they tell me.
Indeed. Indeed.
Yeah.
You know what? Jeremy, I'm proud of you. I think you can be a janitor. In fact, I got you a special gift. I got you a...
Baby.
I got you a baby. Oh, my God.
Vote. This game will be for 5 points. So, did we like the scene from the blue team?
Yeah,
cool. Or did we like the scene from the red team?
That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 points.
Putting red overwhelmingly in the lead. What?
We're making a comeback.
I'm coming back.
Yeah, you'll be fine. Everything's normal. Y'all having a good time so far? Awesome. This next game is the dating game, and let's have Team Red go first here. So what we're gonna do is one person is going to be the guesser, and who is that going to be? That's Mr. Shane. I will say bye, Shane.
Bye, Shane.
And what's happening is that we have three bachelor and bachelorettes who are all going to be on a dating show, and one of them and Shane's going to have to guess who all of them are, and we're going to give those to you right now. So for Lloyd, can we please get an object? He is turning into an object. What is that object?
Marshmallow.
What's it over down here?
A marshmallow.
He's turning into a marshmallow.
Yeah.
I'm into a marshmallow, yeah. And for Seth, can we please get a superhero, like a real superhero that we know?
Iron Man.
Perfect, Iron Man. And for Clara, celebrity.
Kim Kardashian.
All right. So we're going to have all of our dating contestants, and Shane is going to be guessing. How this game is going to work is we're going to time this, and the red team, whoever guesses in the shortest amount of time is going to be our winner. So I'll be timing this. All right. So let's get Shane back up here, and we'll say, hey, Shane!
Hey, Shane!
That's right, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the dating game. Today's bachelor is Shane, and now say hello to your host, Britain's favorite TV show host. Give it up for Chip Birdwell.
Hey, I'm Chip Birdwell.
today we have a very lovely bachelor. His name is Shane. And we have some very lovely bachelor bachelorettes who want to get it with Shane today. So, Mr. Shane, what are you looking for today?
I'm looking for someone who likes to have fun in the sun.
Perfect. Fun in the sun. All right. Well, Mr. Shane, I'm going to give it to you. The floor is yours. You can start asking questions about all of your contestants.
All right. Bachelorette number one. If we went out on a date and I was going to buy you a meal, what would be the first thing you ate off of your plate?
Well, definitely not the chocolate. Or the graham crackers. Is it getting hot?
Nice. So it's gonna be the oysters then.
They're an aphrodisiac.
Cool. Bachelor number two. If we went to a musical play, what song would you be humming when we came out?
Probably something by AC/DC. Maybe a little bit of Black Sabbath as well.
Ooh, heavy. Question number three. What part of your body do you like to have pinched?
Cheek to cheek.
Oh, I get it. Your smile. Question number one. If you were wearing a dog collar, what length lead would you like to have on it?
Oh God, I'm feeling real mushy on the inside right now. Oh man, a leash. Well, I guess I'd like it in the front side. I don't know what the question is anymore. It's getting, oh my God, my fingers are getting fatter.
But you smell good. Question number two. If we were at a concert and I wanted you to hold me up on your shoulder so I could see better, where would you hold me?
I would carry you bridal style, and you'd be over the entire concert looking down. I could even put you on stage. You know what? I'll buy the stage. I'll buy the band too.
Nice. Nice.
Stay still. I can do that.
You can't fly.
Bachelor number three. If you were gonna cook up something really tasty for me, what would it be?
Some diet supplement.
Nice. I can eliminate bachelor number one because I would never date a s'more. Or any other Girl Scout cookie. Because, no? Okay. So, I can't eliminate you, so tell me something fun to do when we go out next time.
Not campfire! Not campfire, please!
So you're just a plain old marshmallow. Oh! I always like them best when they catch on fire. And then the part falls into the fire, and then you only have that little bit left. That's pretty tasty. But that's not what I want to date. Bachelor number two. Since you run a giant tech company.
Thank you.
How much money would you give me if we were married and then divorced?
Well, I'd probably make you the CEO, just because we're married.
Uh-huh.
But... Yeah, I can do that. Sorry, but I think it's a... Something's happening, you know, aliens coming, wolves destroying, and, you know, I mean, you're a nice guy, and, but I gotta go save the world, so I don't know about giving you money. I could give you a nice suit, though. Definitely a nice suit.
Okay, Superman. Or Wolverine. Stan Lee. No more questions for you. Bachelorette number three. I don't think I want to go out with you because you're a famous actress with a company that has all kinds of things for sale.
One of the many things I do on a daily basis. Hope you don't mind my mother hanging around. Or my husband.
Oh, husbands never bother me.
This one might.
For the life of me, I wish I knew exactly who you were because...
Honestly, I don't know why I'm famous either.
If you're the, boy, it's hard to say. How about if, we were going to fight, you and I, how would you kill me?
I would kill you with my butt implants.
Oh. Butt implants. I hadn't thought of that. Bachelor number two, do you have any implants?
Well, I technically had a heart transplant, except I didn't get another heart. I want one, though. I have a heart. There's proof I have a heart.
Oh, yeah. Well, I'm not going to date Iron Man. Hey! Bachelor number three, if we were going to make love... How would you warm me up first?
Well, I suppose I'd put you in my car, and then we'd dash with someone named Ian.
Someone Ian? Someone named Ian.
Oh, it was more obvious in my head than that.
What's your favorite animal?
Oh. I like... things that I can wear. So any animal. Fur out of mink.
A little hint, Shane. If you were to make love with her, you'd be doing it on her reality TV show.
We make money. I've done it before. Do you play football? Or sing? Music.
I don't know if you can keep up with her.
A little hint, Shane, if you got in the car with her, you might be dashing. Car dashing.
I have no idea who you are, but I do like a little junk in the trunk. Kim. Yeah. So I choose you!
Wow.
Thanks for coming to the dating game. Oh, by the way, we have another one coming right up. Everyone say goodbye to Tom.
Bye, Tom!
And he's going to be our next contestant. And so for these folks, for that, can we please get... an object he's turning into.
An orange.
An orange. He is turning into an orange.
Nice.
And for Sid, a superhero.
Batman.
And for Molly, a celebrity.
Clint Eastwood.
All right. And so we know who these fine folks are. It's time to start the dating game.
That's right, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for another episode of the Dating Game. Today's bachelor is Tom, and unfortunately Chip Burnwell got sick. So please welcome his replacement all the way from the Louisiana Bayou, that Cajun host of yours, Old Blind Willie.
I'm off from the Bayou. Hey, I'm Blind Willie. I'll knock me some shrimp from my bobby. Anyway, welcome to the dating show. I'm one dates and no one has peel shrimp. So we got our contestants. What are you looking for, Tom?
Well, thanks, Blind Willie. I know something about darkness, too. I'm hoping to find somebody that'll rescue me from this deep, dark hole of loneliness I'm in.
Oh, nothing to do that like a big crawfish broil, y'all! Okay! Let's get started. We can ask some questions.
Contestant number one. Would you describe yourself as spicy or savory, and why?
Well, once you get past my kind of tough exterior, I'm rather sweet.
Huh. Okay. Interesting. We'll dole out a little more of that later. Contestant number two. If you were a breed of dog, what breed would you be and why?
I would be a poodle because I don't like the bite of the dog. I wouldn't want to bite myself.
You wouldn't want to bite yourself, okay.
Dog's bad.
Tap dance.
Follow up question, contestant number two. Your voice is gravelly. Are you a smoker?
I used to be a smoker, but I tried Nicorette and it worked.
Okay,
little known fact.
Contestant number three.
Yeah.
If I were to slather a sauce all over you and then lick it off, what would I slather you with and why?
Probably have to be the good one. Or the bad one.
The
ugly one.
I guess those are the three options there.
Get lucky.
Contestant number one, do you like it in the can?
I like it in the can, in the box. I'm pretty versatile. I can be put in many places.
I'm sorry, contestant number one. I don't think I can date a pineapple. I don't think I can date a... I really thought it was pineapple. artichoke. But obviously that's not you, so you don't have to worry. Contestant number two, if I were alone in a dark alley and got confronted by a thug, what would you do?
I'd beat the hell out of him. And then I would take you to safety.
Thanks. That really narrows down the superheroes. Contestant number three, I think you're in the lead here. Would you give me like the Grand Torino of your life?
You feeling lucky, punk?
Very, with you, Clint. You are totally in the front there. Back to contestant number one, who's crusty on the outside, sweet on the inside, but isn't a pineapple. If I were to go to a grocery store, how expensive would you be?
Well, typically I'm sold in a bag with multiple of me.
That's a cutie.
Oh, okay. Nice. I am I'm thinking maybe I should keep you in the running. Okay, contestant number three. Let's say I tried to kill your parents. Could I do that? Or are they already dead?
Do you have a time machine?
Okay.
No. You can't kill my parents, they're already dead.
Oh, both of them. Okay, Batman, I'm not sure.
Yeah!
You have too many issues for us. But, I mean, between you and Clint, I think I have to go with you because you're so sweet. Like a tangerine.
Or navel.
Or an orange. I choose you, orange. Squeeze your juices on me.
All right. Well, we found out today that love is real, folks. Now come on down to the box. Give a round of applause. Way under the red person's time. It's Team Blue, everybody!
Yeah!
Come back!
Finish!
Making a comeback. All right, our next game is going to be called Soap Opera. Let's get Team Blue up first for this one. All right, so we're gonna have three people up. And what's going to happen is they're going to be playing a game called Soap Opera. Now, in soap operas, there's a lot of things that happen. So one person must always be fainting. One person must always be gazing longingly into someone's eyes, and one person must always be staring out into the middle distance. And so all of those three things must happen at the same time. If you feel like, oh, one of the pieces of soap opera aren't happening, I need you to snap like this, so that we know that someone's got to go. All right, so to get this soap opera started, what's the big deal today?
No more left shoes.
No more left shoes. No more left shoes. The soap opera. Can we count the soap opera down in?
Three, two, one, action.
I can't go on.
Antonia! I can only find right shoes. I don't have any more left shoes.
My left foot is bloody and bleeding, and I must go on.
No! No!
What?
Oh, it hurts.
You think that because I don't have a shoe, I won't continue? I'll persevere. I'll persevere for as long as it takes.
We can't. Now you don't have any left feet because I stood up for
you. Give me your shoe. I'll put your right shoe on my left foot.
No.
You two! You two sharing each other's shoes!
No!
And leaving me out!
Oh, what will I do? What will I do without a shoe?
Where will we find them?
We'll find them when we find Mother's Inheritance.
Mother's Inheritance?
No!
You guys aren't supposed to know about that, Tom!
We all know! We all know! We all know!
No! You can't know. I was the only one that she told. How did you know?
You were the only one that she loved, but not the only one that she told.
What can it be?
Can we look at her?
Why are you a fighting God? He's dying.
Have we looked in the closets?
I know where the shoe is. I know where it is.
You've looked in the closets, but I've lived in the closet all day.
For this soap opera, same rules apply. What's the problem today?
Gas prices.
Gas prices. The soap opera gas prices in three, two, one,
action.
It started just on Monday. I pulled up to 7-Eleven and the gas prices. It was like a nightmare.
God, they're only $2.22.
They were $2.20 where I was.
Who the heck are you?
I am the gas price manager. And I manage the gas prices.
I think your motorcycle's full.
I budgeted all last month for this!
Oh, I'm feeling a little sick. I think I breathed too much gas fumes.
You didn't breathe enough, sir. Don't worry.
Not enough?
Not enough.
That's weird. I feel so strange.
Because you're so endangered, I got you two cans.
Why do we care about this guy?
Because he needs gas, all right?
He needs gas!
Why don't you care about me? I feel so cheated.
I got two cans for you two.
I feel hated.
I don't need your cans.
Oh, gosh.
I don't need anyone's cans.
Why? I have tried helping you, but you refuse me. Is it because we once belonged?
I need change for a dollar. Anybody got that?
Which soap opera we like best, and we like soap opera from Team Blue! Woo! Soap opera from Team Red! Woo! Anyone with soap opera only vote for one. Team Blue! Woo! Red! Woo! All right, Team Blue gets the pie! Yeah! It's a close game, 1 point apart now. All right, so. There's our final game before we go to intermission. What I need to know is there someone who's celebrating a birthday or recently celebrated a birthday? Right here? Mm-hmm. Awesome. Do you mind coming up for a second?
No.
Awesome. Come on up. And.
I think he said no.
Oh, no.
Okay.
Do what?
No.
Right. Take a
seat.
And what's your name?
Noah.
Noah, everybody. Give him a round of applause. When was your birthday?
Today.
Today is your birthday!
Happy birthday! How old are you?
13. 13, everybody! That's a good year. Well, this is a really appropriate game. It's going to be fine. I know you've seen it. So, this is called Darling, Our Love is Life, and so we're going to be comparing our love to you, Noah, like the objects and things that the audience suggests. And these will be just jokes. And for everyone that gets y'all to laugh, that team gets a point. So, can we please get something that you have, other than a phone that you've had in your hand today?
A key.
A key.
A key.
Our love is like a key.
Our love is like a...
Noah, darling, our love is like a key. You fit just right. Noah, our love is like a key. I'm constantly losing you, and I can't find you.
Our love is like a key. I'm going to unlock that heart.
Darling, our love is like a key. I got spares.
Darling, our love is like a key. I can get a replacement at the hardware store for $3.99.
Great. Can we please get a suggestion of something that's just lying around your car and has been for a while?
Water bottle.
A Kleenex. Our love is like a Kleenex.
Darling, our love is like a Kleenex. I blew it.
Darling, our love is like a Kleenex. The day when I need you.
Oh.
No.
No boy.
Darling, our love is like a Kleenex. It's chafing.
Noah, our love is like a Kleenex. It's disposable.
Oh, no.
Darling, our love is like a Kleenex. I mean, I can use that for any old thing.
Darling, our love is like a Kleenex. I got spares.
Darling, our love is like a Kleenex. I can get replacements at the hardware.
Our love is like a Kleenex. I, too, started using a lot when I turned 13.
Okay.
To be fair, you do get a lot of colds when you turn 30.
That is true. Can we please get something that is laying around your room and you haven't touched in a long time.
Sock.
A what? A sock?
Darling, our love is like a sock. We're a pair.
Aww.
Darling, our love is like a sock. It's like we're always missing a piece, and I could have sworn I just washed it, but I put it in there. But I don't. Where did it go? What?
Darling, our love is like a sock. I got spanks.
Our love is like a sock, Noah. It protects my feet.
Oh, our love is like a sock, Noah, and it fits like a glove.
Noah, our love is like a sock.
And it's hard being green.
2 points.
Noah, our love is like a sock. It's been a few years, and the elastic is kind of getting worn out, and there's a hole in the bottom, and my big toe is kind of sticking out. I think it's time that I let you go. Oh.
Our love is like a sock. We can get a replacement at the hardware store.
Our love is like a sock. It's athletic.
All right, one more thing. Anything at all?
Kim Kardashian's butt implants.
Anything else? What?
Nintendo Switch.
Ah, perfect. Oh, our love is like a Nintendo Switch.
Our love is like a Nintendo Switch for the whole family.
Oh. Our love is like the Nintendo Switch. I don't have one of those either.
Our love is like the Nintendo Switch. I'm going to look at you this whole time and not look at anything else ever again.
Our love is like a Nintendo Switch. It's dockable.
Our love is like a Nintendo Switch. In a bed, on the go, everywhere.
No. No, our love is like a Nintendo Switch. It consumes all of my time.
Our love is like a Nintendo Switch. I don't have a spare.
Our love is like a Nintendo Switch. It's better than all those Game Boys.
All right, everybody. Give it up for Noah, everybody. Happy birthday! All right, y'all, we're at a very close game. 27 points on the blue team and 24 points on the red team. It's a close game! All right, so we're about to take a brief intermission, and so go to the bar, go to the bathroom, do all the things you need to do.
Take
when we come
you.
Back, we're going to have more improv games. In the meantime, follow us on social media. We're all over Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, you know, Farmers Only and Plenty of Fish. Just swipe right for comedy and we're there. Go find us, simply hashtag LaughOKC, hashtag PlazaProv, follow us, tag us, all that cool stuff. When we come back, the conclusion of the improv game! Yeah! Will die at the end. It is a true thing. Our next game, y'all, is called Jeopardy. It is for two players from each team, so they'll step forward. What's going to happen in Jeopardy is these fine folks are each going to be characters, and they're going to be playing Jeopardy, and y'all are going to give the answers. And so they'll give a category. So if they said something like, "I want cereals for 200," you might say Cheerios, all right? And then they'll give you the answer, and it must be in the form of a question, just like in actual Jeopardy, except this is all made up and garbage. Okay, so this is Jeopardy. Can you count to seven? 3, 2, 1. Let's do that again. 3, 2, 1, action!
This is Jeopardy, ladies and gentlemen. Please welcome your host, Mr. Alex Trebek.
Yes, hello. My name is Alex Trebek, and this is Jeopardy. All of these contestants are competing for your love and quizzing with points.
Let's introduce our contestants right here.
Hello! I am the Queen of England. I can't wait to entertain you these days. I don't get out of the castle often.
Queen Elizabeth II.
I just sit about, don't I? Well, I didn't bring my men.
Hello. My name is Fred the God. I run a cheese shop in Wisconsin.
Fred with the cheese! Alright! Our next contestant.
Hi y'all, I'm Miss Debbie Hedrix from Miss Gaddy Bell 1966.
I'm gonna pretend I understood what she said. And finally,
I'm Seamus McDonough. I tell people I'm from Dublin, but I'm not really from Dublin. I'm actually from a town just outside of Dublin, about 25 kilometers west, but I got sick of telling people I was from just outside of Dublin, and I got sick of telling Americans what a kilometer is, so I just started saying I'm from Dublin, and I come back out now.
Well, you heard it here, he's from Dublin. Thanks so much for tuning in Jeopardy, and, you know, the Queen, with all due respect, always gets the points because she's the queen, and so I think it's still her board. So, Queen, what's our category?
Things to do with the daughter-in-law you hate for 200.
Yes.
Dancing.
Dancing. The answer is? Yeah.
What is what you don't want to do at the Southern Baptist Convention?
That is correct. That is correct. All right, the board is yours.
Can I please have movies and things you don't want to watch while on a date?
The answer is?
Pooping.
Pooping. Ah, yes, Seamus.
What is something you can't do after 7 pints of Guinness?
I can confirm that as fact. The board is yours.
I'll take potables for 7,000.
Potables. Answer is?
Perfume.
Yep. What is the beautiful smell of Limburger cheese?
That is incorrect. Yes.
What is my consolation prize?
That is correct. The board is yours.
Can I get S words? For 900?
S words for 900.
Skank.
Yes.
What is my favorite flavor of cheese?
Can't confirm. The board is yours.
Wax for 200.
Wax, 200.
Ralph Macchio.
Yes, Seamus.
Who is the villain in the first Karate Kid movie?
That is correct. The board is yours.
I'll take vintage automobiles for $3.25.
Very specific. Vintage automobiles.
Tractor.
Yes.
What was what I had to ride in the parade in Goaty Bow in 1967?
Correct. Absolutely. The board is yours.
Can I get things that you don't want to do while dancing on a date?
And the answer is?
Unabomber.
What is the singular of a duo bomber?
Weird, but yes. What is yours, Shaden?
I'll take foods for £9.
Switching currencies, all right. £9. Foods.
Dill pickle.
Beef.
Yes, the queen.
The thing I like to party with at night.
Yes. The board is yours, queen.
Oh, things I do to make my own men laugh for 20.
Yes.
Throw pennies.
Beep, beep.
Yes, the queen.
The things I do to my subjects.
Yes, that is correct.
Boy,
the queen.
This is fun.
The board the queen monopolizes the bar. It's yours.
Oh, castles for four.
Castles 400. Yes. Debbie.
I'm sorry, I wasn't arranging my sash. I'm sorry.
We must find out what is the question. What's the answer?
All right, what's the answer? Alex Trebek just took a day nap.
Hogwarts.
Hogwarts.
Beep.
Yes.
What do you get if you don't have cheese?
That is incorrect. That is incorrect. Yes, Debbie.
What's an STI you get from riding on the tractor?
Incorrect.
It's true.
The queen.
My next conquest.
And that's our game. Thank you for tuning into Jeopardy! And now we move on to our next game, which is called Silent Scene. And because Team Blue is in the lead, I'm going to let them go first. So we have two improvisers from Team Blue. And what they're going to do is they're going to be performing a scene, but they cannot use any words. It must be completely silent. We will have some music queued up by our lovely tech improviser, Kenan Lacey. Give it up for our some music, and they're going to have to do the scene to the music without saying any words. So to get them started, where's a great place that you never want to go on a journey to?
Canada,
absolutely. So on a journey to Canada is our suggestion, and we will get this silent scene started when the music starts, but let's go in
three, two, one, action!
welcome. And now we're going to get two people from Team Red. Come on. All right. Yay. All right, remember that scene? We're going to vote for the scene we like the best. So for Team Red, can we get another suggestion of a place to go on a journey to?
Mordor.
Mordor. And we'll get this scene started in
3, 2, 1, action.
Business to take care of. Even though there were no words, I think there was an implied curse word, Lloyd, and you're flipping off.
Shit!
Now that's two. So will you please come forward and apologize to the audience in the form of a poem? I feel we all feel a certain way. Sometimes we think of things and they're not nice things to say. But as I continue on my improv streak, I hope soon to learn
to be mild and meek. To keep going.
You'll accept her. Alright, now, do we like the scene of endless drinking from Team Blue? Oh Lord, Blood Fight, Team Red! So close game. We have one final game for you all, ladies and gentlemen. This is the point when you go, aww. But guess what? We have another show at 9:30, so come back. So awesome. This next game is going to be for everybody. We're going to do a rap battle, everybody. So let's get everyone come up, and we'll have person versus person, and then three people behind that person on each side. All right? So, who's starting? All right, perfect. All right, so what's happening is this is going to be a Beastie Boys rap battle, so they're going to rap in the style of Beastie Boys, because we're white. So they'll go back and forth, and they must continue rhyming with one another. However, the people in the back are their posse, and they have to guess what word they're going to say based on, because it's going to keep rhyming. So we're going to give them one word to start, and we know that that's the word that they're going to start rhyming with. So something easy like sea or boy or...
pickle.
Oh, I can do it.
Okay, cool.
All right. My boys can too.
All right. So Team Red is in 1.5. We're going to start with Red, so you're going to use the word pickle to start, and then we're going to keep going. If they can't get it, if they hesitate, then they're out. And then they will go in the back of the line, okay? And for every person that they outlast, they get a point. So we got Pickle. We're going to start this Beastie Boys rap with that old cadence. It goes... da 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 da
da da da da da da da. When I'm in trouble, I find myself in a pickle. Da 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 da. When I'm in the farm meet, I'm going to use a...
pickle! Da 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 da
da da da da. I'm a little bit
fickle.
When I lick the boots, they call me a licks.
All right.
Run it out quick.
Can we get a new word? New word, please.
Orange.
Drop.
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 And we'll start with Sid in...
I'm telling you my rhymes and you're gonna...
drop.
Drop. When I play the playground, I play some...
arrow! Alright, so who's next? Alright, we're gonna continue with Pop. And... da 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 da.
Going out to school, I want to have a pop.
So I tell my friends, you're going to be
a cop.
I go and I paint squares and I do the pop.
Wait.
I'm going through the schoolyard licking my lummy.
Pop.
This whole scene is just one big flop.
All right. And a new word.
Ham.
Ham?
Ham. Ham.
And...
it was nice Thanksgiving and I had some ham.
I didn't have any. I had to eat
some. Bam! Mary had a little old...
and the doctor died of shock.
Mary had a lamb, and the doctor died of shock.
All right, next, a new word.
Street.
Street. And that.
I'm the toughest on the...
oh, wait. You're going out.
I'm the toughest on the street. I'm...
something on the street.
Something on the street.
Da, da, da.
Continue with street.
I'm the prettiest man you're ever gonna meet.
The blue team
I like to eat
peach.
I never play fair. I always
cheat. I don't like spam. I like its competitor.
Me?
Treat.
All right, and the new word. New word.
Tool.
And
that. I'm no fool. Everybody calls me a tool.
Back up, sucker. I'll take you to
school.
I filled my car with gasoline
fuel.
They call me the king because I
cool.
Not at all anything.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, this is it. This is for, they're completely tied.
So what? Okay.
So this is for the final point.
Oh, no.
It never happened.
This is everything.
So, okay. One beautiful word.
Cart.
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 Cart, cart is our word.
I start.
Yeah. And we'll go and da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da.
When I go shopping, I use a
cart.
I love my sweetie. She has my
heart.
Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Got an A in school. I'm pretty
smart.
I watch Bob Ross. I do my
heart.
Junk, it fell
apart.
When I'm feeling spicy, I feel a little
tart.
When I buy food, I go to the super
marsh.
My car battery died, it wouldn't
start.
I threw it at the board, it was my
tart.
Today I've made some
art.